I got a little bit carried away. Started eating my pretzel before I showcased it. So we've just arrived in Frankfurt and we're at the Mainz game. I don't know how you say it. But the atmosphere is amazing. We're in here from outside the stadium. So just heading in now. Gonna watch the football, have a couple of beers, have a pretzel or two. Then go back to the hotel, get sorted. We're doing the pretzel run in the morning, so 5K. Is it 10 minute mile in? So this is less 5k run, more 5k walk.
Geht auch dann bitte wieder dorthin, holt's dort wieder ab. Der Johann hier.
To sum that up, my 10k PB is 4 minutes faster. What a waste, I was hoping for a good shakeout run. That wasn't a good shakeout run. I must admit, this finish line score, this is probably the best one I've ever come across. So you run in through the building and finish inside the building. Which, it'll be nice if you've got something left. However, if you're dragging your feet or walking, maybe not.
Cheers.
Cheers, cheers.
So what happened after the pretzel run? Put my feet up for the rest of the day, had a nap in the afternoon. I think we ran like 12 or 13 minute miles. I walked most of it. It was just time on the feet, so I wanted to rest up. So I did nothing for the rest of the day. Just went for food. And then on the Sunday, I woke up and the usual routine is a running, you'll know yourself. You go to the toilet as much as you can so you don't during the race. And for me, that meant going four times, which wouldn't be the norm. And I was thinking, it must just be the nerves because I haven't done a marathon for 2.5 years. Just a bit nervous, nothing to worry about, didn't feel unwell. We headed to the start, we got away, and the first 5 miles of chaos because it was amongst loads of skyscrapers. So the GPS just had no idea what was going on. Couldn't pick me up properly. So 5 miles, my watch said 5.5. So my first 5 or 6 splits was just all over the place. And I had no idea if I was running target pace, faster, slower. So that was a challenge, but didn't panic. I just tried to settle. And then as soon as I got to 8K, I worked out that I was about 20 seconds down. So I needed to speed up a little bit. So I just chipped away at it. At about 8.5, started to get like a stomach pain. And I was like, oh, just ignore it, just keep running. And it kind of didn't go away for the rest of the race. So what happened was it would come on for like 15, 20 seconds and go away. It was just like coming and going, pretty much all race. Latched onto a group at about 9 miles and then went through halfway in 1:22:34, so 4 or 5 seconds outside of what I was aiming for, but considering I was 20 seconds out not too long ago, I was quite happy with that, knowing that if I wanted to do it I was going to have to pick it up. Well, I got around 15 miles and I was kind of thinking, it's getting stronger and stronger, I'm going to have to stop. I haven't got a choice really, because I don't want to end up being known for somebody who doesn't stop at the toilet and the whole world sees. I had to stop, so I stopped I waited as long as I could because I wanted to stay with the group as long as I could, because we're nicely ticking along at 2:45 pace. I knew the minute I stopped I was going to lose her, so I hung on until about 18 mile and I dived straight in the toilet, and I was quick as I possibly could be. Probably some kind of record it must have been. I think I was about 40-45 seconds and straight back out. But then the rest of the race was on my own, and if I'm completely honest, the thought of, oh, this is just awful, crossed my mind, and I thought, should I drop out? As those sort of thoughts do, but kind of the stomach issues and going to the toilet just added extra weight to that argument. So I basically put that thought to one side and ignored it and cracked on, pushed as hard as I could. Sub 2:45 had gone. Yeah, I was starting to feel it at about 20-21 miles. So I was pushing and pushing and pushing. It just wasn't meant to be. So I crossed the line in 2:47:41. The feeling was amazing, because having the race that I did, and to run a massive PB, I ran 7:21 PB. Was just amazing, because I didn't expect that. In the closing stages, I was waiting for the pace to just fall off a cliff and jogging it like 8 minute miles, and it didn't happen. Super happy. Missed the goal, so there's a little bit of disappointment there, but that's completely out of my hands. There's not a lot I could do. So to still run a big PB and not be a million miles away, this gives a lot of confidence for April going forward. Gonna get straight back to it and then have another go. So that means that I've missed the qualification for Berlin for 2020, but that doesn't mean I can't do it for 2021. The aftermath was not nice. So I finished the race, had a quick chat to Steph Twell, asked her how our race went. She ran an Olympic qualifying standard, so that was great to hear. And then after that, unfortunately, spent the next 90 minutes in the toilet, thrown up and on the toilet. Yeah, not fun. At a point I was just like, this is just hell. That's the worst I've ever felt after a race. And it took 2 days to get over, so I couldn't eat for 2 days. I went and had, went to a traditional German restaurant, and I ordered a rump steak. I thought, rump steak with veg, get that down, that'll help us out. Couldn't eat it. Give it to Dan and Stephen. Monday was much the same. I could kind of have like a little bit of food, but anything more than that, and I just started to feel really bad. Just nauseous and need the toilet. And so I think I probably had some kind of stomach issue going on, some kind of stomach bug or something, but taking nothing away from the performance, so, because I'm over the moon. And I wasn't even like, well, what if this and what if that, because I was just so happy with the time. That brings season one to a close. It's been fun, didn't quite achieve what I wanted, but absolutely over the moon with what I did achieve. So pretty much planned out what I want to do for season two. Gonna step back in the world of ultras. I'm gonna have another attempt at sub 2:45 at the start of April with the ultra at the end of April. And hopefully gonna pick up a drone. So that should add another dimension, that should be good fun. Thanks for watching, really appreciate it. See you for season two.